YouTubers, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Boy, I bet this was unsettling. Late last night, there in Poland, that would be their time, there was a magnitude 3.59 earthquake. The only one that reported it was EMSC. They said it was a magnitude 3.4. Here it says that the house moved terribly, and they were 1 kilometer southeast from where the earthquake occurred. Another one said, the feeling of moving the bed during sleep, furniture shaking. This structure usually happens at night or in the morning. I've talked about how a lot of these earthquakes do happen at night. I don't know why, but they do. Another one says, quake woke me up. Another one says, another quake from the mine. Now, they're assuming that it was probably a mine blast or whatever. Let's see. Plaza near Horseradish. Okay, and then we got another report. This is about 15 kilometers from the epicenter, around 4:52. I assume that would be a.m. their time. Bed shaking, something slipped, some sort of plastic box standing on the edge of an unstable object. Despite a gentle and maybe lasting two second quake, fear of small cracks in the walls. So I wonder if they got damage. Here's the seismic signature. Yeah, it's mostly the fault moved. You see sharpened points, tectonic in nature. There is some rounded ones. Here you can see on USGS magnitude 2.5 or greater. Past week, they have nothing. For all earthquakes in the last 30 days, the only thing they have is Romania. That was a deep earthquake down there by the Black Sea. 152 kilometers in depth. Or 94.7 miles. Yeah, this other one was Greece. There is 6 volcanoes listed there in Poland. Nothing recent. The last eruption was 3 to 4 million years ago. And let's click on that. That is in the southwestern part of Poland. They have an image of it here. And let's go to Google Earth and look at the location. So here's the location of the 3.4. All right, sorry for the interruption. Yeah, my daughter called. So let's go to where that volcano is supposed to be located at. And I'll mark it and then we'll move it out so you can see there's that little hill. Yeah, you can kind of see with the trees, the circle. So it says the volcano is a conical-shaped, eroded volcano that was active in the Neogene period. More specifically, the volcano is a volcano neck made of basalt. I guess that would be the plume, what was left after the erosion. The geology around the hill is composed of sandstone and a conglomerate of Permian age. The hill is protected by a natural reserve since 1962. All right, so let's bring this out. Yeah, Poland does not have a lot of earth. Now you see we got an area up over here. What's the date on this? There was a 4.7. Which was this year, April 7th. And yeah, a lot of earthquakes there that I was tracking. All right, so let's go back out to where this recent earthquake was, right there. Okay, from there, let's draw a line so you can see it better. Okay, let me move this out of the way and go from there to the volcano, which is 267 kilometers. Let's go to miles. or 166 miles kind of northwest. Being so close to the border with Savonia, I know I'm butchering that name. And what else do we got here? In Ukraine. Okay, over here is Ukraine. When they have earthquakes or any type of shaking, they're probably wondering if the escalation has started with you-know-who. Yeah, Poland has built up its military and has bought weapons from the U.S. and NATO. Yeah, they're preparing. Because over here, we got Belarus, which we know, there's been a buildup with Belarus, with the bear. Yeah, and they're talking about how Belarus will probably invade Ukraine coming from the north. So Earthquake Discovery has it posted on Twitter about 14 hours ago. Some of the more recent Twitter post, it says United Arab Emirates sending 2,500 generators to Ukraine. Half of them are already in Poland. IINM and UAE also sent us some military staff. Good partnership. And we've heard the talk about military people there in Ukraine. No wonder Poland has been increasing its military and buying as many U.S. made weapons as it can, because they believe Russia when they say Poland should not exit. And no, Russia would rather invade them if they are not strong. Not much about the earthquake. A lot about what's going on there. It says up to 200,000 Poles are being called up for military training next year. Notes from Poland. They include some who have never put their names forward for service, but have been deemed to have useful skills. That's interesting. The exercise can last up to 90 days, and failure to attend is punishable by jail or fine. During that period, reservists receive an army salary, which would, in many cases, be a private pay, about 25 pounds or 117.13 Zerloft. The pool of people who can be called up are those age 55 and under who have been through so-called military qualification, which is compulsory for all men turning 19, and during which the candidate's health category and fitness for military service are deemed. Under the Homeland Defense law adopted earlier this year, the qualification obligation also applies to women graduating from medical and veterinary schools, as well as from psychology courses. You got to go to school longer to be a veterinarian than you do have to be a doctor. Did you know that? Poland will increase defense spending to 3% of its gross domestic product next year, one of the highest levels in NATO, to protect itself from various Imperial Russia. Its new Homeland Defense Act will also more than double the number of troops serving in the armed forces. Now, a colonel for the Central Military Recruitment Center says that I assume that it will be the minimum number of people called up. He said people who have qualifications have a certificate category, but have not been to military training. Doctors, nurses, paramedics, IT specialists, drivers, and lawyers. This is a narrow group of people who have specific skills and specific qualifications, and those who can serve in the Polish Army would be very useful. When asked for a specific number of call-ups, the colonel suggested it could be around 3,000, and they would have only 2 days of training to get familiarized with military equipment. They would then be reissued to a passive reserve. But nothing posted about the earthquake, and I don't see really any serious or any really potential aftershocks that were going on. Yeah, this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Let's go to the spectrogram. Yeah, poor people. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Make sure you're still subscribed, because YouTube likes to unsubscribe people at the end of every month. They think you're bots. anyways, what's that? There's something right there as I'm yakking here. Yeah, we gotta, let me make that one bigger. Let me pull this over. It looks like a little quake there. So, once again, always be prepared, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.